you got to promise me you're not going to use the cell phone while you're driving or try the texting. It has to go in the glove box, okay?
Okay.
And so that's going to be rule number one. And if there's an, you know, if there's an issue, if I...
Cell phone calls and texting increase crash risks significantly, and teens are particularly affected. Research shows that texting while driving can take your eyes off the road for an average of almost...
I just don't even realize it. Because we're talking, and, like, sometimes I'll, like, look back to answer somebody just because it's out of habit to look at someone when you're talking to them.
Okay, so let's try to keep the amount of people in the car to a minimum.
Okay.
I understand you're going to want to have your coffee and things like that, but, you know, the problem is if you're not going to keep it in the cup holder or keep it close by...
What I think they're trying to tell us here, though, if you read this, is that kids who have good grades tend to be more conscientious drivers. Do you think that would be the case?
Absolutely. When we were growing up, that was, like, a really big thing. So I think it's been really drilled into people's heads. But I'll just, you know, make sure that everyone is wearing a seatbelt. Okay. Sure.
Okay, so why don't you sign there?
Okay.
Okay, so
sounds good to me.
Okay, there you go. All right. We'll just say no driving at night. At night. Okay, and then you can sign here, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
Because we liked him until he made that whole scene. Until he made that whole scene.
I've never heard you guys complain about anybody.
No.
This is very bizarre. That's why it concerns me, because I've never heard that.
Right. So it's just like...
Yeah.
I think Brooke's going to start going to therapy, though, just because, like, she...
I mean, I think she needs it.
Big time needs it.
To be honest,
so, no, she does.